Okay, second classification is Volterra equation, and Volterra equation of the first kind, f of x is equal to integral a to x k of x comma t phi of t dt, and a Volterra equation of the second kind, that is phi of x is equal to f of x plus integral a to x k of x comma t phi of t dt. First kind parnyala endayirunno unknown function is inside the integral sign. Second kind parnal endana the unknown functions are inside and outside the integral sign. Volterra equation nu parna enda, if one of the limit is variable, then it is called the Volterra equation. Then why do we bother about integral equations? After all, the integral equations have done a great job of describing our physical world so far. However, there are several reasons for introducing integral equations. Okay, that means you know there are so many kinds of differential equations, and then why we are using integral equations then? That means differential equations can represent so many problems in this physical world. And there are several, we are using integral equations. What are the reasons for introducing integral equations, or why we use integral equations? The reasons are, first, we have placed considerable emphasis on the solution of differential equations subject to particular boundary conditions. That means, last sem la ningal differential equations padichittundavum pala type lalla. Pum boundary conditions apply cheyidittulla differential equations padichittundu. Pinne nammala Bessel function padichittundu. Alla. Newman's function. For instance, the boundary condition at r equal to 0 determines whether the Newman function is present when Bessel's equation is solved. Bessel differential equation solve cheyumbol, the boundary condition at r is equal to 0 predicts whether the Newman function is present. Okay? Newman function exists cheyunnundo ennu ee boundary condition aanu determine cheynathu. The boundary condition for y r tends to infinity determines whether in of r is present in our solution of the modified Bessel equation. In our modified Bessel equation, in that solution, if in of r is present, is determined by the boundary condition r tends to infinity. To the contrary, an integral equation relates the unknown function not only to its values at neighboring points but also to its values throughout a region. Adayith, integral equations allengi solve cheyina samayath unknown function boundary points le certain values ayale matram depend cheyyunnathayittalla kaanunnathu. It depends to the values throughout a region including the boundary. Boundary include cheyyunna oru region le throughout represent cheyyunnathayittanu kaanunnathu. In a very real sense, the boundary conditions are built into the integral equation rather than imposed at the final stage of the solution. Adayith, you know, while solving differential equations, we are imposing the boundary conditions at the final stage. But in the case of integral equations, the boundary conditions are built into the integral equations. It will be seen later in this chapter that if we construct an integral equation that is equivalent to a differential equation with its boundary conditions, the form of that integral equation depends on the boundary condition. That means when we construct an integral equation, the boundary conditions are all are absorbed in it, or the form of that integral equation depends on the boundary conditions, and in the case of integral equations, boundary conditions are not imposed at the final stage of the solution. The second feature of integral equation is that their compact and completely self-contained form may turn out to be more convenient or powerful formulation of a problem than a differential equation. Integral equations inde ettavum pradhanapetta oru property nu parnal endana, it is compact and completely self-contained, and so it is more powerful, gives a more powerful formulation for a particular problem than a differential equation and its boundary conditions. Mathematical problems such as existence, uniqueness and completeness may often be handled more easily and elegantly in integral form. That means you know the existence, uniqueness and completeness of certain mathematical problems. It is handled more easily and elegantly in integral form. Okay, and finally, there are problems such as some diffusion and transport phenomena that cannot be represented by differential equations. Okay, there are some problems like diffusion and transport phenomena which are not represented by the differential equations. If we wish to solve such problems, we are forced to handle integral equations. If we wish to such problems like diffusion and transport phenomena, we are forced to handle the integral equations. Atharathirulla problems solve cheyanamengil nammal endu thanne use cheyanam, integral equations thanne use cheyanam. That is why we are bothering about the integral equations, even though the differential equations can describe a lot of problems in this physical world. Okay.